Good evening, everyone. It's so lovely to see a full Carnegie Music Hall, and welcome to everyone who is tuning in on our live stream. You'll forgive me for not memorizing my remarks. My brain was a little full with what I just did. But the past 250 days have been a very exciting adventure. It's been orchestrated by many ambassadors, many of you who are here, and all of them who are listed in the program, who have requested performances of this concerto for people far and wide. I've discovered places and people that I would otherwise have never met, and it has been a really beautiful experience for me. I have been inspired by the stories of people that I have met, people who, despite ALS or chronic pain, grief, whatever it may be, find a way to live a joyful life. And when I probe a little more deeply, each one finds a different way, but it all seems to be because they are directing their focus on creating joy for other people. I've been asked, how is this 50th performance different from the first? And I wish I could tell you that it's so much easier and that the concerto practically plays itself. I don't think that that will ever be true, but what I can tell you is that after a year of living with a great work of art, I have assimilated some of that power. I feel that when I share that with other people over and over again, I am strengthened by the power in each of us, and for me that has been a really transformational experience. What have I learned from this? I've learned that suffering isolates us, and that isolation creates more suffering, and that there is no antidote quite as immediate and powerful as live music among friends. I don't know that there is any pill or technology that can take the place of human interaction. And although I was really ready to be finished with this after this evening, I have to say that the line of requests is, still exists, and there have been many people who have asked me to return, to expand, and to continue in some way. And so, if that is a desire in the community, if this is something that you would like to see continue, I am prepared. And the Edgewood Symphony kindly is prepared to continue as my sort of fiscal sponsor through the end of this season of 2020, which is the Beethoven year. And I'm ready to expand to involve other music and other musicians who might be able to fill that need, because I have discovered that there is truly a need for the healing power of music in our community. If this is something that you would like to see happen, there are two things you can do, and they're both sort of outlined in your program. One is that you can request a performance on behalf of someone that you love, and that can very easily online at www.beethoveninthefacet.com. You can make that request for a performance, or you can stop at our ticket table in the lobby and make that request. Similarly, if you would like to donate to support the musicians who are going out and doing this work, you may do so in both of those ways, again, online or at our ticket center or in the lovely little donation boxes that you might find out there. So we will continue to perform and to document these performances for you on the website for as long as the community would like us to do that. Now, before we move into the lobby for some Beethoven birthday cake, there are some thank yous that I would like to get out there, and so please bear with me. It's, things like this do not happen all by themselves or for all alone. So first, I would like to thank my two amazing teens, Isabel and Tino, who have been my most ardent supporters for the past year, who have had to suffer through my practicing this over and over again, hundreds of hours. I think they know every single note. They've had to make their own dinners while mom's out, playing on the weekends, and have been just absolutely wonderful support to me. My 14-year-old son, Tino, in fact, has accompanied me. He was my rehearsal pianist, and he played 38 of the 50 performances with me. I would like to thank the wonderful Edgewood Symphony behind me. These are when we performed this the first time last March, I don't know that they knew what they were in for, but they were so gracious in believing in this mission. And Natalie Kasievich, who is the president of the board, and Walter Morales, both were so encouraging in supporting this for the community. So I truly appreciate their being here on their on Monday night, bringing your time and your talent to the stage. So appreciated, and also for the Edgewood Symphony for being my fiscal sponsor for this project. Great thanks to every one of the ambassadors who made a request and organized a performance. You have invented an entirely new performance model, which is community driven, and it's a beautiful thing, and I truly appreciate all of your efforts in making this happen in the community. I'd like to thank all of the other musicians that you have heard and will hear. The Congolese youth that you heard in the lobby is Tino Cardenas, who played the jazz piano, as well as the Bruderhof community, who is about to sing from us. They came all the way past Uniontown to be here this evening. And the Mariachi Internacional de Pittsburgh. This is also a wonderful group of musicians that I met on my tour, and I'm so glad that they're going to be here to celebrate with us. A big thanks to Carnegie Mellon School of Music, specifically Dennis Colwell, who was the head of the school and offered such generous support. To my colleague Andres Cardenas, who graciously loaned me this Stradivarius to be able to play for you this evening. And to Rich Kaywood and Michael Bridges, who made it possible for us to live stream this and take care of all the tech support here. Very quickly, also, Elena Chester is my managing director, my right arm, my left brain, the one who, when I realized this was far too much for one person, stepped in and organized everything that you see here and took care of, really took care of me. So thank you, Elena Chester. And to my six CMU grad students and alumni who are my lobby team for this evening, thanks for all of your work. Also, a big thank you to Michael Savisky, who made the beautiful documentary film that you saw in the lobby. He is also here filming this evening and will probably snag a couple of interviews. So if you're eager to be in my movie, you can go talk to him. I am very grateful to the Drader Foundation, who underwrote most of the expenses for this project, and also very grateful to David Milstein and John Lloyd for underwriting the cost of the hall rental so that all the proceeds from tonight's concert can go to the work in the community. Thank you so much. And now, last but not least, I would like to give my sincere thanks to Ludwig van Beethoven for his gifts to humanity that have inspired us for over 200 years. And I felt that to honor him, to honor the spirit of this season and the spirit of this project, we would end with his iconic Ode to Joy, sung by the Bruderhof Choir and Community. Please stand and sing.
Thank you.
Bravo, bravo, and thank you so much for preparing that. It's just beautiful. So now it's a special birthday serenade to Beethoven that is going to then lead us all into the lobby to enjoy some birthday cake. Please welcome Mariachi Internacional de Pittsburgh. They're going to play Las Mañanitas, which is a Mexican birthday serenade. Enjoy Beethoven birthday cake and let's celebrate. Thank you all so much for being here this evening for the celebration.